The end of day two of this next-gen test here at Daytona is coming to a close, and I have John Probst, NASCAR Senior Vice President of Racing Innovation, standing here with me. A long 2 days, but it's been a productive 2 days for NASCAR. What do you think of these two testing days at Daytona?
Yeah, I think you wrapped it up pretty well. It's been a long 2 days, and I would say that we're really happy with where we netted out here. I feel like this was a pretty good extension of the test that we did in Atlanta about a week ago. We were able to dial in the package a little bit more from when we were here later in 2021, and pretty happy with where the speeds netted out. And I think if anybody was watching online, they would have saw the group run we did yesterday was pretty darn good racing, and some of the drivers got out, and we're talking about, man, they're racing hard already, and, you know, there's no money or points or trophies on the line. So I think that, you know, when we come back here in February, we're ready to put on a really good show.
It didn't take long for the drivers to mention, you know, the 7-inch spoiler, the 510 horsepower, which will be our super speedway package for 2022. It seemed like a pretty easy decision once the cars got on track, was it?
Yeah, obviously, like, in hindsight, when you put it on track and everything looks the way it did, it looks really easy. But I can say, you know, there's a lot of hard work that goes on back in the R&D center, you know, with Eric Jacuzzi and Brandon Thomas running all of the numbers on this to make sure that, you know, when we unload, we're not going too fast or too slow for that matter. And everybody did a really good job. You know, we had a good, like I said, a good test in Atlanta to confirm some of this stuff before we got here. Big thanks to the teams for all the effort they've put in. The feedback they give us is instrumental in us getting to where we're at here today.
One more test left for this next-gen car before the season starts, and it'll be in Phoenix, which will be a very different package than here at Daytona. But what are the goals for that test later in January?
I think the goals for that test are, you know, obviously Phoenix is an important track, you know, not only to us, but to the teams. Our championship event is held there. So it's obviously one they all have marked on their calendars to show up and be very competitive at. You know, from the NASCAR perspective, we want to go out there and make sure that, you know, as the track rubbers in, we got really good Goodyear tires, which they've done a fantastic job through this whole project with us, making sure we've got the right stuff on the cars. I think as far as the package goes with the high horsepower and the low downforce there, that's certainly something our drivers love to drive. And I think that, you know, we've done enough testing. We've been to Phoenix already with our prototype cars. I would anticipate a pretty good result coming out of Phoenix.
All right, John, we appreciate it. I know it's been a lot of hard work in the offseason, but enjoy it and soak
it in.
We're close. Thank you.
Thank you very much.